used to have everything, you know. The girls and the car, the money. Yeah, man. Yes, you know. But nothing my virgin turned them back on me, you know. Talking about they don't like the way we deal with parents. Them man that some fool rasta come try to run my life. Them are idiots. Can't tell me nothing, rasta. Let me tell you something. I have the brain power to give this up tomorrow, you know. I don't make this control me. I control this.
Couldn't your drugs up like now in confidence free on 0800 77660. That's 0800 77660. This is Genesis Radio working for the community.
Just this work, a sizzler, so that when I put it down now.
The people station, the people station. Genesis FM.
Genesis Station. Educating the younger generation. Shots on my.
Oh my goodness. What would I do without Genesis?
Hi, this is Phil Catella, and I tune into Genesis because they reach.
We are the people station. We are the people station. We are Genesis FM. Genesis FM, London.
This is the Raggo Chat Show.
Doctah.
Done. Yeah, yeah, London town, you're done now. You just get the big show from the Metro Love crew. Big up Metro Love. Chemist, Mr. C, Mr. Speng. You're done now. It's all about the Genesis flow on the 916. Right now, you know what it's all about. It's all about that Raggo Chat Show time. You get me? Dr. X, the Ghetto-ologist, the one and only, along with the KB and myself, the Ray Don. Seeing tonight's show is entitled, Are You Ready to Block Out of Jail? You get me? You don't know, it's not only one physical jail you're getting old by, you get me? Enough psychological jail and enough bad mind and fuck up jail, you get me? That certain people want to stay trapped in. They don't even want to get released. But hey, what? We're blacking out, trust me. And Dr. X has come to free certain of the prison too, you get me? Dr. X, what are you saying, King?
Yeah. We're in the house, what? Yeah. Another one again, you know, I keep getting this all the time, don't I? Like, what? People are complaining about my fucking swearing all the time. What the fuck's wrong with them? You get what I'm saying? Leave it out, mate. If you want to complain, is there a number? Is that working? There's a number, it's 07977-884840. Don't complain to the management, yeah? Phone the show and tell me what your problem is, yeah? Because I've told you, we're going to play for you the Profanity trailer in a minute, yeah? You're sensible people, you're adult people, yeah? If you don't like what I'm saying, don't listen. Switch off, you know what I mean? You can't listen to every single show, can you? So there are certain shows that you don't listen to. You know when they got all the Batty Man them kissing on Channel 4 and you're not into it? You don't watch it, do you? You get what I'm saying? When they got all of that stuff going on, you just don't watch it. And the nakedness, you don't watch it. So the simple thing is, yeah, don't complain to management about my swearing or nothing. Yeah, because that's how we do. You get what I'm saying? Just switch off. say that, well, this show is not for me. Let me just go and watch telly or do something else, or, you know what I mean, wash the dishes, or, you know what I mean, play two domino, two card. You get what I'm saying? Till I'm off. You get me? So, will we, blood? We're going to run that, and like, you break out of that little prison that you're all in. You get what I'm saying? The ghetto prison, the prison of your mind. You get what I'm saying? That's what we're trying to help you to break out right now. You get what I'm saying? So, like, you know what I mean? Either stay with it or get the fuck out.
This is an adult certified program. It is designed with a mentally mature audience in mind. Profane language will be used in this program, and the presentation will be unorthodox. The aim of this program is to discourage the fantasy principle and to encourage the reality principle. Please do not continue listening if you are disturbed or offended by any of these factors. The bottom line is, yeah, it's all about blatant, upfront, Dr. X, raggle. So if you don't want to listen, turn your radio off. You are about to enter the surgery of Dr. X. You are about to enter the surgery of Dr. X. You are about to enter the surgery of Dr. X.
Escape.
Yeah, yeah, listen. It's time to escape. You see what I'm saying? Too many of you, right, don't seem to like, you know, stuff that's part of your culture, yeah? Right, so, like, what we're saying is that the whole thing, is too much negative people out there, right, spreading too much hate and too much disharmony. You get what I'm saying? So, if you want to break out of that prison, you got to start to clean up your mind. You get what I'm saying? Because right now, certain, you see, like, you'd like Almino and the brother and Ray Don and KB? You get what I'm saying? We're breaking out. You get what I'm saying? You can't hold people like us anymore. You get what I'm saying? That's what it's all about. You get what I'm saying? The reason why we're on this station, the reason why we're saying what this, we're saying, the reason why we're going on like how we're going on, is that you can't hold us no more. You get what I'm saying? Them days are over. You get what I'm saying? And once we've got a platform to start, we can't stop enough. That's what we're saying. You get what I'm saying? We're on a jailbreak thing. You get what I'm saying? Because there's a long time they got us locked up in this. You get what I'm saying? They don't want Rude Boy to say nothing. They don't want to pretend like they want to bury their head in their sand. They don't want to pretend like we don't hear. We've got another set of youths them who you know, went to Sunday school and church and everything like that, trying to act like they're Rude Boys. Certain boys who've never mashed ants in their life. You get what I'm saying? Trying to act like they're there. You get what I'm saying? And they're not there. So what we're saying now is that we're breaking out, star. You know, all the Rude Boys, all the rude boys out there, you know, all the brothers on lockdown, you know what I'm saying. You get what I'm saying? There's only certain and certain man's going to be there. Are you a soldier? Or are you a gangster? Or are you a drug seller? What are you? You know what I'm saying? What side are you on? Who are you fighting for? Or are you just fighting for yourself and your own personal survival? What is it? You get what I'm saying? We're breaking out of this star. I'm that Rude Boy.
Listen keenly.
Before the yam of the day start, hey, I feel great. The one of the prisoners, them hate.
Break out.
Flip on a very patriot. Yo, I feel great. The one of the prisoners, them escape. Run out to live in the field. Yo, I feel great. The one of the prisoners, them escape. Flip on a very patriot. Yo, I feel great. The one of the ghetto youth, them escape. Come inside.
Get an utter.
Yes. The emperor, Selassie, I Rastafari, so great. Mounds, I am the singer, he full of people. Rastaman got the fate till I see left it at your men's at King's house. Do we patriot? What's all me pretty don't be great? Them talk about we kill, them talk about we rape. The mount of blood that don't speak.
Rock out them religions too.
Disgrace, I them all come tarnish the human.
I we not in a nope.
God is and get dumb in a face with us. Babylon and the dust, we put them on them face. Them make the money when them have we a dealers.
They can't always.
So I them always I put out the case, them sell them curfew. Never sold them rate. Who go in farm and go to the jail? Them send the police and sort of feet come raid. Them run up in a beaver man grenade.
Listen.
In a brimstone and earthquake. In a slavery, black man them come slave. Them say a black woman.
The message.
Charge him, no more your cash here. Get a look at any dawn, them get freed. That's the man at any dawn, them get freed. Babylon, you can't make me black woman. You know me, it's real great. One of the prisoners, them escape.
Listen.
Don't want to live in the
come chat that culture again. You get me?
Really back to the heart. Yeah, you know, yeah, where must I say, right? Send a message to all, to the rapper them.
To the shatter them.
Better time now you start chat culture again. Means that the 2000 new things are coming, new soldier. You say Rasta soldier, and them soldier, because Rasta was the first, and you know, Rasta build. All soldiers offer that, you get what I'm saying? Because we not deal with no religion. We're not Rasta man, and we're not no Jehovah, no, we're rude boys, you get what I'm saying? But rude boys are soldiers, we're on that. You get what I'm saying? That's what we're on. So therefore, tell all the shatter them and all them boys, they say time, full time now, them chat culture again. Hear this slicker part.
One of them escape. Black woman are repatriate. They want to hear break. They want the prisoners them escape. Come to the living need to be
black out.
They want to hear break. They want the prisoners them escape. Become to move the mountain with the vent. It was a don't tell to be the list. You side warrior, warrior, warrior. What you never see it.
Warriors are warriors.
That's where you go live. Tell them to we they
are soldiers are soldiers.
Send a message to the rapper them. Shut at them, tell them watch at them. Lightning flash, send a clap at them.
Hear that? Full time. Problem. Again, again. Black out. No trace, no trace. They can't trace we.
Brave hearts, nigga. Live.
Brave hearts. Lion hearts.
Me, y'all don't live it up.
All soldiers. Calling all rude boys. Nigga. Calling all rude boys.
Get yours, baby.
Get yours.
Yo. As the night closed down on the earth like great dark rings. Lighted cities in the night, destination for kings with their dreams. Like Castro, overthrew by
where you headed?
Cuba, and pointed nukes toward the U.S. About to shoot us for revolution. That's how you gotta move, a lot of rules. Some locked in solitude, cursed the day of their birth.
Sadia Brocco,
who's to be praised? The mighty,
a ton spare parts.
Allah, I'm like the farmer, planting words, people are seeds. My truth is the soil, help you grow like trees. Made the children come in all colors, change like leaves, my hope before you. One of those prophetic MCs with blood and flows, 700 souls in me. He's channeling for past and present time. Heaven shines light on those innocent to how the world goes. Some men become murderers.
Hell, want you to do?
And you accounted for everything that you heard. Do not speak to fools. They scorn the wisdom of your words. My heart is wise. Bloodshot eyes. The sovereign never dies. Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise. 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 Ghetto prisoners.
Ghetto prisoners.
God's children, habitats in tall buildings. Rats crawling filthy hallways, incinerated.
Rise up.
Through faithless, still is hope, prayers answered. Dreams turn real. What's a wicked nation? One with blind men, not taking charge of the situation. Empty arguments and real conversations needed. The world are needed to hear it. Evil tried to weaken my spirit. This chronic herb, this hurt come from the honest.
You're a prisoner.
My heart is to serve my maker. What I learned found its way on the paper. So I could dictate it.
You're trapped.
Bladed. Luckily,
all up in the matrix.
The ships that made it through strong currents and winds that left the other strength.
Record, record.
The Atlantic, Satan jinx the planet. Not to get too religious, but who decides
what's in KB?
Finished and price is in us for the sake of your name, oh Lord.
All the Raggo youth.
Away from the chains.
All the rude boys.
Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise. Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise. Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise. Ghetto prisoners, get up, wake up, rise. Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise. Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise. Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise. Ghetto prisoners. You wanna buy time? I'm the seller of minutes. I give you every second low price. If I sold lies, the truth is time waits for none of you. In fact, you can't wait for the date to snatch the ground.
Find your way out.
Small visions are better.
Out of madness.
Right, look in the mind.
Free your mind.
It's ahead of their time. Trapped in the slums, begging for nothing but taking.
And the rest of you will follow.
Pin where their cousins be waiting. Judges is not relating to pleas. Guns busting where the kids play. Ricochet off lamp poles and leave damp holes. And bystanders get canceled.
That's a prison.
Around the way where we from. Hope the future reduce the rate of those buried young. Life is every man's kingdom, a dying man's past, and a newborn, first time to be here at last. It shouldn't have to grow up fast and suffer our pain, hustling harder than the generations here before he came. Going through the same bullshit as our fathers. Read the history, but who's the authors? For some the game is easy, for most of us the game is much.
Know yourself.
Lose faith, through the years just get smarter. Ghetto prisoners.
ghetto prisoner.
Do this.
Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise. Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise. Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise. Ghetto prisoners,
get up, wake up, rise.
Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise. Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise. Ghetto prisoners rise, rise, rise.
Ghetto prisoners. Yeah, you done know. That's how we're rolling. All you there stuck up in the matrix. Free your mind, style. It's an illusion, mate. You get me? You go around, it's just big, you know what I mean? Work, come on, bills or whatever. You understand? Just going around in that same old circle. About time that circle broke and you bust out of the pack, you get me? Cause what? 400 years is too long, style. You get me? And time we're done with the fuckery. You get me? Start fix up and do things, you see me?
This is an adult certified program. It is designed with a mentally mature audience in mind. Profane language will be used in this program, and the presentation will be unorthodox. The aim of this program is to discourage the fantasy principle and to encourage the reality principle. Please do not continue listening if you are disturbed or offended by any of these factors. The bottom line is, yeah, it's all about blatant, upfront, Dr. X, raggle. So if you don't want to listen, turn your radio off.
I used to get feels on the bitch. Now I throw shields on the dick to stop me from that HIV shit. And niggas know they soft like a Twinkie filling, playing the villain, prepare for this rap killing. Biggie Smalls is the illest. Your style is played out like Arnold and what you talking about, Willis. The thrill is gone, the black Frank White.
Experience. That's the ticket.
Bitches are like I'm brainless, guns are like I'm stainless steel. I want the fucking fortune like the wind. I squeeze gas till my clips is empty. Don't tempt me. You don't want the fuck.
Here I am, I'll be damned if this ain't some shit. Come to spread the body leverage over harmony great. It's the new killer death trap. Yes, I'm a jet black ninja. Come in where you rest at, surrender. Step inside the ring, use the number one contender. Looking cold booty like your pussy in December. Nigga, stop bitching, button up your lippin'. From method, all you getting is the can of ass whipping. Hey, I be kicking. You, son, you doing all the yapping. Acting as if it can't happen. Your button got me mad enough to touch something.
Oh, you fakers.
Allen, and ain't afraid to bust something.
Day's done.
You won't, nigga. You won't, nigga. I got a six shooter.
Only the realest
trigger
can feel this.
94, rugged raw. Kicking down your goddamn doors.
Something like
fuck
this.
The world, don't ask me for shit. Yeah. Everything you get, you got the world all for it.
Honey, shake your hips.
You don't stop.
Them niggas pack the clip.
Keep on.
Verse
2. Coming with that OE bro.
Don't ask us for shit.
Niggas back and I see you. I'm lifted, true. You can bring your whack.
Get yours.
I connections. I get that ass stuck like glue. Huh, no question. I be coming down and shit. Your wife is rugged as a motherfucking carpet kit. And niggas love it. Not in the physical form, but in the mental. I spark and these cells get warm. I'm not a gentle. I'm a method man. Baby, accept it. Most respected.
Assume the position.
Stop, looking, listen. I spit on your grave. Then I got my Charles Dickens.
Go to my center. Honey's feeling deep in their placenta. Cold as the pole in the winter. I'm the inventor. Well, I got this rap shit sold. And when my Mac I'm loads, I'm guaranteed another video. Ready to die while I act that way. Pop Duke left Mom Duke. The faggot took the back way. So instead of making hoes suck my dick up, I used to do stick up. Cause hoes is excuse me, flows just grow through me. Like trees to branches, cliffs to avalanches. It's the praying mantis, deep like the mind of Farrakhan. A motherfucking rap phenomenon. Plus,
I got more glocks and text than you.
I make it hot.
Niggas won't even stand next to you.
Nigga touch me, you better bust me 3 times in the head. Or motherfuckers dead. You thought so.
Fuck the world, don't ask me for shit. And everything you get, you got for it.
Honey, shake your hips.
You don't stop.
And niggas pack the clip.
Keep on. Fuck the world.
Listen, can you hear that? Can you hear what I'm saying? Can you hear what he's saying? Everything my after work hard for it. You understand? Nobody not give me nothing. When I get nothing free. You understand? So don't come to me and ask me for shit. unless you're down with like the program, unless you're about like stepping up, unless you're about trying to free your child's mind from the jailhouse. You get what I'm saying? Unless you're about trying to free your auntie's mind from the jailhouse. Unless you're about trying to free your father or your mother's mind from the jailhouse. Because a lot of these people are in jail. Fuck the world. Don't ask me for shit. You know what I'm saying? Everything in life, I got to work hard for it. You get what I'm saying? Whether when I do my exams, whether or not I get a job, whether or not... So what are you on my case for? You get what I'm saying? You don't need to be on my case. You need to find some other case to be on. You need to find Lee Jasper and then Monday. You get what I'm saying? Who claimed to represent you and you have vote for and then Monday. You need to find them Monday and ride for them case and phone up for them people them. And the house of commons and tell them what a stupid job them are do. Them people that you need to talk to, because them people that is what's running your life at the moment. Me not run your life. I'm doing the work. I'm on the radio station. I like to big up the mystery lady for phoning in and giving her. I don't think you'd like to hear the mystery lady because she's dark. You get what I'm saying? If you think I'm dark, she's dark. So therefore, some of you people, them, you need to expose yourself. You don't need to be hiding in the shadows. Like, so what do you call these? They're like germs. Just waiting to release. You get what I'm saying? Don't hide in the shadows. I don't care if you're male or if you're female. You get what I'm saying? Why do you do things like that? You get what I'm saying? Why do you do things like that? We've got, I mean, this is principle we're talking about, yeah? Why are you going behind people's back and whispering in people's ears about me or about the show? Come up front. You get what I'm saying? You're perpetuating that same low-life mentality, whoever you are, male or female. You understand? Because there's no point, there's no real reason for that. If you've got a problem with me, that's why the ghetto's so messed up. So. You know what I'm saying? You see a man do something over there, so instead of you go say, boy, I'm gonna like what you do, bridging over there, so whatever. You go tell him friend, and him friend tell him other friend, and everybody else, you want to see, boy, you want to see, you know, my boy. It's them thing that them people they love, and them talk that them love. You know what I'm saying? And I'm saying that, don't talk behind people's back, man. You got something to say, either say what you got to the person, or don't say nothing at all. You understand what I'm saying? That's jailhouse business, man. That's ghetto jailhouse business. You know, see what the show's called today? Don't you want to break out? You know what I'm saying? Enough ghetto youth to break free. And I'm not talking about ghetto justice in terms of illiteracy and can't read and write and swear and cuss, be a bad word. I'm not just talking about that ghetto. I'm talking about anywhere. You get what I'm saying? Because I know that in any set of estates, you got people doing A-levels, you got people doing, you know, got in certain kind of jobs. So just because they say ghetto in terms of England anyway, right, in a ghetto of England, it's not like the ghetto of Jamaica. You get what I'm saying? The ghetto of England is not like the ghetto of Bronx or New York. You know what I'm saying? So when you look at Lewisham and Peckham and them place there, you have enough little house in the state, ghetto. You have some fresh building where them are built, which in another 5 or 6 years, where you say, all heap of black people in another 5 years or 6, 7 years, it's going to be a ghetto. You understand? Because it looks good. Wait, what you don't realize is that it looks good when they first build a house. Like, oh, remember when Angel's Estate was first built and them thing? When they first built, all these estates, when they first build them, it looks all good, nice housing. The people who move it in there first think, they get a nice place and rare. But the thing is, they've got you all bungle up there. So by the time your youths reach 16, 17, now, bare things are gone. The house them start run down and they become a little ghetto. You get what I'm saying? So as I was saying before, there's all types of people in these ghettos. A-level students, you know, working class people, certain people who think them stush and nice and rare or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So therefore, when I'm talking about the English ghetto, it's not the same like Jamaican Zinc House ghetto. When five people are living in one room. You understand? And certain people, them have to teeth all electricity. Them have to link all electricity from one yard to another and them thing. So it's a different kind of ghetto. In a ghetto over here now, the most thing a man used to do would say squat. And then link up the electricity himself from in the house. You understand? So it's a different ghetto, but it doesn't change the fact that it's still a ghetto. Maybe not as bad, because certain people were saying to me that, boy, you never come and go to America and say proper ghetto. What do you mean proper blood? What do you mean proper ghetto? What is a proper ghetto? The worse the place is, the more proper it is as a ghetto. How you work that out? A ghetto is a ghetto. A ghetto is a place where poor people live and a poor class of people bungle up. Like the Jews. The first ghetto, like I said before, was the Jews living there. The term ghetto don't come from black people. The term ghetto come from Jewish people. Because they bungle them all up one place. And it's only them, mostly them live there, so. All kind of manner and species of them. You understand? So ghetto don't mean, say, the worst of your housing. So Jamaican ghetto is worse than, is the proper ghetto. And English ghetto is not the proper ghetto. Brazilian. You ever got a Brazilian ghetto? What? So South American ghetto. Which is the worst? South American. We are measure ghetto now. We are measure which ghetto are the worst ghetto and which ghetto are the best ghetto. You know, see, it's all black people living all them place there. That's all you need for really knowing now. You don't need to know which one is worse and which one is better and which one is clean and what. They're all ghettos. Where they bungle up black people and give them the worst housing in the state. This country's a risk country. So therefore, their ghetto is a slightly a bit up from another ghetto. Jamaica ghetto isn't as rich as England. That's why everybody fake them passport and I come to England. Why do you think so much Jamaicans want to come to England in these times? Because there's no money in Jamaica. They make money here and they send it back. They buy passport over here. You know what I'm saying? And they get married over here. They buy their stay over here and they marry girl over here to stay, or they marry man over here to stay. They breed for man even to the point, because they know that the immigration people are watching them, and they will even breed for a man if it's a girl, and a man will breed a girl and say, this is my family. You understand? Just to stay in England. That means there's something here that they need or they want. They don't necessarily like England. And they all move from one, so you move from Kingston ghetto to Brixton ghetto. Acme ghetto. Them don't move from yet. Them don't move from ghetto. Them don't move from Kingston and go live at Hampstead East, you know. If you can only move to another poor part of whichever country you're going to. So if you go to America, you're not going to move to uptown Manhattan. You're going to move to downtown where? Bronx. Brooklyn, them places. That's where you end up. You understand? You end up anywhere where there's poor housing and poor people and black people. Anywhere you go from like Brixton, that's where you're going to go. From Kingston, that's where you're going to go. From Brooklyn, that's where you're going to go. You're not going to go from there to Manhattan or Hampstead Heath. You know what I'm saying? Or from Cherry Garden, from Brixton to Cherry Garden. You know how to go, sir. You're going to go wherever the poor housing is. Maybe you might even get a little chance with their own, like Patrick City and them little middle of the road places there. But you know, go straight uptown, you know. So know that, you get what I'm saying? You got to stop them little foolishness there. Big people doing this. That's what you used to do at school. You remember Chinese whisper? You whisper in somebody's ears and then whisper in somebody's ears and then by the time it gets around, it's the wrong thing them I say. That's what happens when you talk behind people's back. You understand? That's what happens. So it's no good you're talking behind my back, because that's all you're doing. If you're going to go, and I've got a show, the number is 07977-888-4840. 07977-888-4840. Ring the show. Talk to Radon. Talk to KB. You know what I'm saying? I make you know when I feel out there, if you don't like that. You get what I'm saying? But don't go around like that, because that's all arms house business. You know what I'm saying? And the Raggo Chat Show is about exposing all that, you know what I'm saying? Because we're soldiers, we're not on like a bad man thing and rare. Bad man to a point, say, well then, yeah, we would defend it. But not bad man in the sense that we're badder than this time, rare. No, we're not dealing with that. We're dealing with like unity in the community and by any means necessary. That means, say, if my cost too bad, word for getting pint across, then that's what I'm going to have to do. Because if any of you, like what the mystery lady said, never swear, or never know about swearing, then... You know, living in a totally another zone, so you know, come from somewhere else for me to know about. You understand? And because we're trying to break through, we're trying to break down certain barriers. You know what I'm saying? Because like I said, when Channel 4 has got their swearing or ITV's got their swearing, I know none of you are not phoning up. You just turn over. If it's the two batty man a kiss on television, then I'll watch that. I turn it over. Me not phone up Channel 4 and say, guess what, I have two batty man a kiss. Me now, just turn over the telly. So anything we don't like, you have the choice to switch out of it. You understand? Because we know we can't stop this Babylon business, yeah. Everybody talk about Babylon. Everybody talk about what they, you know, this and that. And a lot of you out there, play that tune there, yeah, star.
Yo, sing them up, find them up alive. Be a bottom and them come down now and arrive.
Ban them.
Sing them up, find them up.
Be a fire.
Good mama return.
And it's gonna get hotter.
Yo, sing them up, find them up alive. Full time, they will not burn out the dirty vibes.
Yo, full time, them up, burn out the dirty vibes.
This mama return and not them can't survive. Lord, keep me, you said that the boy got took a dive. We sparked him diving at the one lucky price. Same city go half and you made from the outside. Big tongue, the ball on him, it just collide. This summer, it's in where your head got in the vitamins early in the morning. And
we're not wrapping up.
Rub most of those and all the lush eyes.
Certain things have to get exposed.
Full of full time, them get twice. Bully, sing them up, buying them up alive. Baby, come on, them come round, you are the prime. Yo.
Trying to divide the people, then we get me that can't run.
Yeah, you hear what he's saying? A pure black woman in my deprived. So he's talking about some little batty man and them business there, yeah? So what I'm saying is these things are going on, right? And nobody's not opening up their mouth. They're just on each other. like some liquor, what them call it, crab in a bucket and all them thing there. You get what I'm saying? It's like, you know, you don't want to see an next man live. You get what I'm saying? You don't want to see an next man rise up. You know what I'm saying? But you will continue, right, to let those people who fake, like the mystery lady says, all them little fake people is what you keep on. Somehow, I don't know what is wrong with black people. Somehow you seem to feel comfortable with who is false. You're letting somebody through who's lying to you, and you know, and you're sitting in your house and you talk about the lies that they're telling. But all I can hear from my show and what people echoing what I hear back through other presenters and through the radio and through people who listen to the show is that, yeah, what you're saying is true. You know what I'm saying? Whether them are like the story or not, that's what I'm hearing. So why is it that we got these mystery people? You know what I'm saying? Egg, they say, he's saying, this is a DJ, Cableton, who's saying, egg them up and egg them up alive. You know what I'm saying? Because it look like, say, the enough of them are turned from woman and turned to man. And from a longer time, the Afro-Caribbean lifestyle has never been like that. A lot of these Jamaicans have come to foreign, you get what I'm saying? And they're turning homosexual in their outlook in life. They're accepting a lot of things that they said they wasn't part of. Because enough of them, you know, Jamaica's a Christian country, it's not a Muslim country. You understand? So enough things they're supposed to be banning. But it take a Rasta man, you know, a Baba dreadlocks, yeah, to be standing up and fighting. You know what I'm saying? Right now, Cableton is the hottest DJ out there in this man's books, in the Dr. X's books. Because the rest of them, they're not on it. He's on a continuous fire thing. You know what I'm saying? Until whenever I feel him fire out. But that's what he's on. You get what I'm saying? Showing you that. You know what I'm saying? So there's man like me who's getting inspiration from knowing that, boy, at least, man, not everybody I talk about gun shatter and shatter and shot this and crack this and, you know what I mean, sex the girl and sock the, you know what I mean? Everybody's talking about that. Some people are looking at other things and saying, bunny. Now, another man saying, boy, not everything you're out there, you're for burn. Because we have a man like Albini, man, now. I say, not everything we're out there, you're for burn. But at the same time, I'm saying, has the world gone mad? You know what I'm saying? So, in theme, outlook, I'm not dealing with. But I'm saying that this man's on a constant fire burn. Him say, to hat it, I go get atta. Him say, bonfire. Him say, hang them up alive. Because what? He's saying that, as far as an African Caribbean person is concerned, the way we were brought up in their so-called Christianity is that we lick out against Batty Man. You understand? That's how we was brought up. Afro-Caribbean, I'm not talking about nobody else because I don't know about nobody else. But the guys them are wearing Versace, which is a homosexual, the man who was unknown, he's got his family is homosexual. Yeah? Man, I sing pan them song, yeah, me, I wear Versace and Armani. And then on his next song, he's saying, fire for the batty man them. So that doesn't make sense. That's hypocrisy. These things have to be brought out. That is that's why people can whisper and susu. Because a man will see a bad man in a Versace and not say a thing. Because I'm afraid he might get a shot in him, whatever. You understand? Whereas you should be saying, check the man there going, I see my way batty man clothes. Because that's what it is. Listen, hear what I'm saying. I'm not fighting them down and saying you shouldn't rear. What I'm saying is this. The hypocrisy of talking about fire for batty man. Every dance you got to, every tune we run, not every tune, but enough tune, I talk about lick out against them. While the youth them, the same man they about, oh, I got bow, fire and lick shot and a flashlighter. They got machina on. You know what I'm saying? So it shows their lack of intelligence. You know what I'm saying? It shows their lack of intelligence because they're wearing Moschino and Moschino is another homosexual. So what is this? I don't understand. Tell me. Because you're confusing me. That means if you're confusing me, you're confusing the youth them because I'm a big man. So if you're confusing me, then the youth them are confused because they don't understand it. Yeah, fire for the batty man, lick out against the batty man, then Moschino had a big thing. Versace had a big thing. The whole set of these European designers, yeah, most of them, if not, how much of them, blood? 80% of them are batty man. So before now, we had Carl Carnite, who is a black man who you know, love gal. Exactly. People even big up Bill Clinton, everybody realize, say, him love gal. You understand? Our woman, our sisters, whatever one you want to call it. You understand? Yeah? But yet, nobody now buy Kanye again, even though I'm still a millionaire still. Versace. Because them hear about Englishman or England are wear Versace and Polo and them thing there. Yeah, right? Yeah. May I tell you something? America don't know about fashion. Versace, Armani and all them Monday is European fashion. So if America talk about fashion and talk about Versace and Ray, they're talking about European fashion. That means we had it first. You understand? The baseline, let me tell you again, let me tell you about fashion, how things switch around. Yeah, the baseline where the American them are used now, them get it from Jamaican. But they make it sound bigger and broader because them have more technology. You understand? Boy like Puff Daddy and all them man, they get their vibes from Jamaicans. It's the Jamaican onslaught that has changed a lot of the music in that country, the Jamaican immigrants. You understand? And it's the Jamaican immigrants in this country that has changed a lot of the mindset of the youths them in this country. So Jamaican people are very, very forceful. They've got a very, very strong will. The only difference about it is that the will is aimed at the wrong, well, not the wrong, but some things that have fuck up the community. Not necessarily bigging it up. You understand? And we need to change that will into something where I learn about something and I change things up. You know what I'm saying? Because the youths them need to know about education. They don't just need to be educated. They need to be brought up. You understand? That means that they need to be taught about life. They need to be broke out of them jailhouse there, them council flat jailhouse. You know what I'm saying? You know, see, all in people like Brixton and Lewisham, them are bringing people for buy out the place them. And I leave the poor people them in a poor estate. You know what I'm saying? We need to start to educate the youth them. Because what's happening is that we're becoming diseducated. You know what I'm saying? And miseducated. You understand? So we're squanning. Them kind of fire that, you know what I mean? Them kind of thing they're not supposed to go on. We're supposed to change up them thing there. You get what I'm saying? Man supposed to spend time with them youth them. Now you not have 12 youth all over the place and now watch over them. You know what I'm saying? Them coming like straight, them coming like when you lost all sheep. You understand? A man must do better than that style. A man must know how to run it. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, if you don't have your shit together, it's gonna mess up the rest of the community. Because everybody connected to everybody else. You understand? You know what I mean? Don't get me wrong. I love Jamaica. And I was there the other day. Like I said, 96, not the other day. 96. I'm into that. But I'm dealing with the reality of what is truth we're dealing with. We're not dealing with what we think. And we're dealing with truth, what we know. You know what I'm saying? Not what we think, but what we know. What we know is guanin. You know what I'm saying? What we know is going on. The people, them are shot in crack in the ghettos, them. You know what I'm saying? Like heroin is going up. Enough man who you know was all good one day. How much of you know man who's been shot? How much of you know man who's cracked out? Drugged up. How many? So it's clear, isn't it? It's clear what's going on. We're being messed up from the inside. Know your enemy. Know your enemies. You know what I'm saying? Hey, we had to deal with something serious, you know? You know, I deal with something. Everybody, like this tune saying, like, hang them up. You get what I'm saying? Hang up all of them, look up. Anybody will say, hang them out. You get what I'm saying? Make people know who they are. You get what I'm saying? Don't encourage that little backbiting, so. Double standard, hypocritical. Don't encourage that. You get what I'm saying? What are you encouraging that for? If somebody's going to whisper something in your ear, say, well, boy, I tell that to the man. I'll whisper something, say, well, listen, talk to the girl about that. Don't talk to me, because when you talk to me, then you're going to say, me said this, and me part of the long argument, and the, you know what I'm saying? That's what's happening. We've got a lot of uneducated people in the country, yeah, bringing their uneducated lifestyle with them. And it's catching on because enough numbers of them. You know what I'm saying? They need to fix up. They need to learn how to have control over their lifestyle and where them I deal with. You know what I'm saying? Every Saturday is the same thing. Dance, dance, dance. You know what I'm saying? So that's why there's so much idiot DJ out there, because it look like everybody just want to dance. So we have a only little part-time DJ who don't know nothing about music except for where them ear punch eyes. Or where the DJ play where the guy playing at the record shop where the new song will come in. So them play all the power up. Sometimes no man got them dance down, oh man god. They just play rubbish. Because they don't know what is a good tune from what is a bad tune. All they know is that either this tune is doing it or this tune, I bought this tune this week. So that means it must come play. Them kind of weirdo. There's too much of them. You know what I'm saying? Like Stone Love, everybody wants to talk like what? You know, what's the new talk? Wow wow. You know what I'm saying? Big up. Wow, wow. You know what I'm saying? It's like everybody, like Jamaica is like what? You know what I'm saying? It's like people are happy to look at Jamaica and say, well then yeah, everything with them come out, if it's a new dance, if it's the butterfly, if it's the pram, whatever. You get what I'm saying? Everything is about there. And I'm saying, well, what about us then? Coming like we are the puss of all in all this. You get what I'm saying? I mean, people are buying yourself. You get what I'm saying? What about them? And what about the children that you're breeding and having here? You're not giving them no sense of respect for themselves. You get what I'm saying? Everything you look abroad for. You get what I'm saying? That don't make sense. That means you're weak in the fabric of the society that you're creating. That don't make sense. No foreigner out there, a big up American artist and a big up foreign artist and a big... And I'm not saying there's nothing wrong with them. But everybody must have their... Where's Phil Connor there? Where we dip on the internet? Anytime we go to Jamaica, I've been there. They don't like English people. They think English people are stupid. or they show off and they got enough money. Because there's a whole set of idiot people who's gone out there showing off on their little borough money, their little partner money. Going on showing off on people because they learn it from English people to show off. You get me? And that's what's going on. That's what we're up against. That's what we have to live with. You know what I'm saying? So when all the street youth them go out there now, like man from off the road, who live more earthly life, who live more street life and that, they you know what I mean? A man have to like get catch up out there, catch up with certain man out there because what? Man think they're idiot, and man have to say what? You know what I'm saying? And what? You get what I'm saying? And push out their chest and say what? I'm not one of them idiots if that's what you're thinking. But what? Because you hear some English. You know what I mean? America's the same. You know what I'm saying? They don't respect you. You get what I'm saying? I remember one time my brethren went out into America, New York, and he was walking down the road, and he that time he was locked up. And certain boy move out of the way, and he's a gang of them too. Because just because he was a dread, this was not now, back in the day, yeah, they thought, well, yeah, he was on something. You get what I'm saying? Bad boy and rare. Because they never know about dread them time. There's only since soul to soul go over there, them start learning about dread. You get what I'm saying? Just the other day, I go out like say them, and everybody just bow to the beast. Yeah. Pray to the great God America. The great God America. The great God Puff Daddy. The great God. You know, what happened to them band there? None of them man they weren't worshipping. Not one of them. None of them not there upon nothing star. You get what I'm saying? Not one of them there upon nothing. So what? Chat, man.
Yo, sing them up, bang them up alive. Be about to man them come round now and arrive. Yo, sing them up, bang them up alive. Good mama,
this is certain things we're talking.
Yo, sing them up, bang them up alive. Full time there were
no mince words.
Yo, sing them up, bang them up alive.
No mix up thing.
Can't survive. Lord, sweet me just so that the boy got to cut dive. We sparked in life and I get one lucky prize. Same city go half and you make from the fourth side. Big tongue that my lightning head just collide. This summer it's an oil head gotten divide.
For those who want to say something,
in an admit sun arise.
We'll soon link up the live link.
Blush eyes to eyes.
So get ready.
Pull up full time, then get wise. Bully, sing them up high and them up alive. Be a black come on them, come round you have the prize. Yo.
That's how they divide us. Divide and rule. You're a fuckery. You're a disease in the community.
They're
force feeding you.
Them never said that might them would not pick it up, would not take it out. So they say it obvious. And if them never bat him and them would not pick it up, would not take it out.
You hear that?
Obvious. And if them never corrupt them would not write it up. Yo, I know. But not you know now only what he went next. But not the owner who is at the body text. But no idea how the owner will be a bun next. But need for a
bun. Bun them, bun them.
Bun back by the town, they back by the death, but it's my bun next. Me can't say I'm hopeless. Me can't call on you cause it will mash up the press. What next? Send them up, bind them up alive. Be a watch on them, come round down and arrive. Yo, send them up, bind them up alive.
We don't want them round away.
We don't want out the dirty vibes. Yo,
hold
them, bind them up alive. Good mama, turn them on, try to deprive. Yo, send them up, bind them up alive. We don't want them,
hold
them. You know what I'm
hold them.
Then no make your time so, and no make and rest of all I never teach you feel it so. And I make you dance up, and I make you dance up.
So what are you learning?
You can never teach you feel it so. Yo, it's illusion, confusion, temptation, corruption. I guess of them there, I guess of them there.
Guess of them there.
Them my youth are in the sleep where them are sleep. Cause I guess of them there, I guess of them there. When I think how them I think I'm in the link. Who them I link. Cause I guess of them there, I guess of them there.
Where them there?
That's who them I less and we not trust. So them I just, I guess of them there.
We don't trust what them I trust.
Be a batty man, me a say come from down there. Be a side of mind, me a say fire down there. Be a wobby man, me a say hang up.
A death of them there.
The informer, buy up down there. Unlight the fire, make me burn out down there.
Burn them out.
I can't go. Sing them up, bind them up alive. Be a batty man, them come round down and arrive. Yo, sing them up, bind them up alive. New love, cover not the dirty vibes. Yo, sing them up, bind them up alive. London, cover not the dirty vibes. Yo, sing them up, bind them up.
Stop promoting it.
This can and the hand, none of them can survive. Lord, sweet me heart, I gotta get a star. Red, I gotta get red. Red, I gotta get rubber. Black people, it's a go bit of the tower, you're dear man.
I gotta get a gun. Run. I gotta get better.
On top.
I gotta get rubber.
Burning, burning.
I go,
burn them. Burn them. And you know what they say? You can't take the heat. Get the fuck out the kitchen. Don't ask us for shit. Oh 7 9 7 8 4 8 4 0 7 9 7 8 4 8 4 0. That's the live link. You got something to say? You phone that. Negative, positive, whatever.
Yeah, can we hear where you are at? Hello? Hello, 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 hello. I've lost you, Where is it? Where?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, we got you.
Yeah, it's Leah from Camberwell.
Leah?
I'm just ringing in to say, you know, big up, respect your show. And I don't know why they're complaining about you cursing, even though they got a warning at the very beginning.
Okay.
To switch it off. So, anyway, keep up the good work, yeah?
Thank you. Yeah, right, nice then. One.
Bye.
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Yeah. See, this is what I'm saying, yeah? There are people out there that appreciate the truthfulness of the Get the Raggo Chat Show, yeah? They appreciate it. So we want to know, that's what, what we're trying to explain to people out there who are positive and are more upfront, or trying to find their mind in this, you're trying to free themselves or trying to break free of the jail of what they've been imprisoned in, yeah? Mentally, yeah? The Ghetto-ology is about that. Yeah, Dr. X is about that. Ray Don KB, the Raggo Chat Show is about that. You understand? So, what are them other people about then? You know what I'm saying? Because they're not phoning the show. You get what I'm saying? But yeah, we're hearing about what they're saying, about who they're saying it about, and all that. You get what I'm saying? So, it's strange, isn't it? It's a strange phenomenon. Can you see how we're living as people? Can you see how we're allowing certain people up in our space? Can you see how we're allowing certain people to do things, and we rise to kind of like, what do you call it? The bait. You get what I'm saying? By letting these people up instead of saying to ourselves, saying to them, well, no, listen, you go one side with that. You get what I'm saying? Too much of that. You get what I'm saying? And it's like Leah said, yeah? There was a warning at the front. So that's sensible. If you're an intelligent human being, what more do you want? What more are you asking for? When, you know, when you see a 18 on a record or so you know it says, the white people them got it sussed. They got PG. If parental guidance, that means young people can watch it. Yeah, I'm saying, this, you know, 15, 12. You know what I'm saying? I mean, how much more do you people need? Run that, Ruby.
Yeah.
Highly leaders of the world, only me I talk to. Look how long in the day I pressure black people.
Yeah.
400 years and we don't have nothing, man. You mean you can tell them, say, watch out. I said a full-time filly called Pandy Evil.
Yeah.
All the leaders in the world for them a living devil. Well,
yeah.
See, the Pandy mic star now go idle.
Yeah.
Come in, what say me a father, bless disciple. The
yeah.
Almighty inspired me. Fi talk to Uno when me say Uno. Talking about fi me people foolish. Me now go talk because star not able. I fi educate me people and tell them something. Now look how long we they are and I strive through and struggle through
yeah.
Them who are. See the black man have no. Nothing fi wipe out twin nation now where them a try fi do.
I gotta stop that plan. Listen, this is the KB, you know. This is like, listen, this is the KB, you know. Only, you see, this is how we work. The Dr. X, you get what I'm saying? KB, Radon, yeah? He's flung that together himself. Now listen. He's joined for tunes that are apparent from the selection and to the point from the selection. You get what I'm saying? That's the KB. You get what I'm saying? You know, like, sometimes you got to hear what's out there, because music is the food. You get what I'm saying? So, and you know, that's what we're trying to show you, that a lot of what's being done to us as a people is being perpetuated through the music. You know what I'm saying? True ragga, true soul, true reggae, you know, the same, true hip-hop. You get what I'm saying? The people of them are chatting about some dark, nasty, disgusting things that's making the people on the street think that dark, nasty, disgusting things is all good. You get what I'm saying? I'm not saying people not to talk about sex and rare, but we're talking about the killings, the backbiting, the things that red eye and bad mind, the things that they're always thinking about and kind of bigging up. Or if they're saying, well, the girl, they're bad mind pan me, and it's always about me, not saying, well, let's stop the bad mind. Let's look at another way to think about things. You know what I mean? If that person's doing that, let's look at our situation. Even though we know that a part of the government has a lot to play with putting us in certain situations and the money situation. But you see, the mind is a great, 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 great tool. You get what I'm saying? And it can bring you out a lot of things if you know how to focus it. But because we're so busy, narrow-mindedly in this prison, only focusing on the four walls, yeah, that's what makes us so insecure and insular and turn on each other. You get what I'm saying? You need to open up that space in your mind and bruck out of that prison. Jailbreak, as we call this show. You know what I'm saying? Get free of that. You get what I'm saying? And don't let nobody encourage you to lock the door on your own self and dash away the key on yourself. That means you're an idiot. Run it again, KB.
All the leaders of the world are who me talk to. Look how long, you know, they oppress black people.
Yeah!
400 years and we don't have nothing, man. You may look and tell them, say, watch out. I said a full-time filly called Pandy Evil.
Yeah.
All the leaders in the world for them are living devil. Well,
yeah.
See, the Pandy Mike star now go idle.
Yeah.
Come in, no, say me a father, bless disciple. The
yeah.
Almighty inspirate me. Fi talk to Unu when me say Unu. Talking about fi me people foolish. Me now go talk because star not able. I fi educate me people and tell them something. Now look how long we they are. And I strive through and struggle through
yeah.
Them who are. See, the man have nothing. If you wipe out twin years and now where they might try if you do long time they might try, but it now got simple. All the leaders in the world of them were responsible, them
yeah.
Too corrupted, wicked and evil. For them oppression me people 24/7, cause them a devil. Father curse out of heaven. I said a full time feel like all
the yeah man, it's just the black redemption of black people together. Yes, you know me, I should have said I
am life. Yes
yeah man, you only get to use up on the river
now. No other than
stand firm outside your diamond.
No other than no other way.
Free heal them, you get to your trail. Babylon, you are the unreal. Me, I tell you now. Heal the black nation, get ill. King Rastafari, bust this.
We're real.
Me, I tell you now. Deal, no pain, no wrong deal.
That's how we run it.
The Raggo
Fair. Raggo.
We'll get to you, no other.
91. Genesis. This is the surgery. Healing the sickly. Mentally sickly. Psychologically sick. Mentally imprisoned. Brocco. Where is the sizzler? Where what? Same way, KB.
This is the Raggo Chat Show on Genesis 91.6, bringing power to the people. Power to the people.
Them your black woman real. Babylon, you are the unreal. We are tell you now. Heal the Afghan children, them get ill. Rastafari, fly the set to steal. We are tell you now. Deal, no brain, no wrong deal. Oh, God, you're a real, get to you, no bother still. Righteousness, we appeal. Aye, long time I have tried it.
Done the fake thing.
Black people go.
That shall fade
this
away.
Is the Raggo Chat Show. This is the Raggo Chat Show on Genesis 91.6, bringing power to the people. Power to the people.
Studio number 07-977-88-48-40. The live link's open.
Let's see if you got the balls. Anything you got to say? It's your opportunity, mate. 07 977 8848 40. Big up Leah. Wanna enjoy the show, sing. Easy, mystery lady. Glad to know you're still listening, me.
Alan, got you there? What? Who's that? What have you flicked over? Hello?
Mr. Lear, still listening.
Oh, see.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's all good then, yeah?
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah, see. Go to.
Big up, big up.
Big up, yeah? Right, what I'm saying is that. Are you running that?
It's alright, mate.
See, that's what I have to do to the live link.
Larry,
yeah? Yeah, so. Stop, we got to, like, you see, like it said, real, them your ghetto youth real, see what I'm saying? So we might not be Jamaican from no zinc house ghetto, you understand? But we are ghetto youths, you get what I'm saying? We're from that, that's where we were brought up, in that arena, you understand? So anything that we are learning, we've learned from that ground up, you get what I'm saying? The intelligence is there, anything that you want to know is there, you get what I'm saying? So those of you who want to test the level of the ghetto-ology, you just have to phone up. There's no ignorance involved. You get what I'm saying? If you're scared because you're not used to dealing with a particular mentality, that's my problem. If you believe I should be going, well, good afternoon, good night. We're having, you know, this is the Raggo Chat Show. If you believe I should be talking like that, you're sickly. Hello, this is Genesis.
Yes, what's I was name? Wondering if you could help me, right, by sending out a message to... you know, our black youth. My neighbor's son was, what should I say? 11, he was waiting at the bus stop. And 11 black boys crowded around him from Woolwich wanting to fight him. I mean, we have got enough out there to deal with, you know, than having our boys fight themselves. I've got a 16-year-old son. He's 5'4", and he's stopped by the police, sort of thing. You know, not only do we have to put up with outside forces, we have black boys trying to kill or beat up other black boys. You know, we need some togetherness.
Most
something definitely. As mothers to say, look, this need to stop. We need to get together and fight outside forces, not to be fighting amongst ourselves.
That's true, that's true.
So if you could really send, you know, this message out to those black boys in Woolwich coming to Greenwich, maybe, you know, they would gather some sense
and
think before they act.
Yeah, thanks for that. Yeah, I will do that. Yeah? Thanks. What's your name, sorry?
Annette.
Gillette?
No, Annette.
Annette, okay, thanks,
thanks.
You take care. Bye. Yeah, seeing, you see what I'm saying? This is the problem that we're having. You know, she's saying that people need to get together, right? But it's you know, it's the man them. There's 11 black boys on one black boy. You get what I'm saying? Where did they get that? Well, I mean, where did they get that from? They're getting it from their fathers. You get what I'm saying? Because each one of them boys has a mother and each one of them boys have a father. You understand what I'm saying? It's something to do with the mothers and fathers stuff. You know, they need to like to take a hold of their children and know who their children are. You get what I'm saying? They need to take a... Them brothers in Woolwich should be ashamed of themselves. But they're not really... I don't think they're going to be ashamed of them. They're going to think it's a laugh. They're going to think it's a kick. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, they're like, you know, instead of being lions, they're like hyenas and them little wastridge animals. You know, them little scared, drunker animals. You get what I'm saying? They're not no man. You get what I'm saying? But their fathers there, obviously, must be their role models. You get what I'm saying? Their fathers must be their big role models, not being their, you know, bare soft story and rare. So whoever their fathers are, they're part of the bit to play. Whoever the mothers are, they're part of the bit to play. You get what I'm saying? And that's the problem that we have. You get what I'm saying? Too much of this may have 12 baby mother and all that kind of... That's what's causing that. Because you can guarantee out of them 11 guys, maybe 11 of them don't even have their dad around. 11 of them out of the 11. You understand? Or you know, at least of, what, 70%, 80% of them? That means at least 9 of them. You know what I'm saying? That's what we've got to contend with. And it's hard. How can we help each other then? How? What do we do? You get what I'm saying? What do we do with that? You know, the discipline is lacking. You get what I'm saying? A lot of them youths, they don't know nothing. They will chat to you anyhow and you have to thump them over. It's not, you can't even act, you know, it's like to say, well, oh, what you need to do is to talk to them. Talk to them out. Talk to them out. It's not, they're not like white children, you know what I'm saying? Who you can, and even white children, they're just as bad too. So it's not like saying that, oh, it's only black children that you'd want to. There's enough white children that are causing a havoc in the care system and all over the place. And with their parents, and you know, I'm watching certain shows and seeing that, you know, these nutters on their estates and all that. So it's not just black kids, but what we're saying is that as black people, it's full time now that the man them play a part. They stop looking for a girl every Saturday night and drinking out their tenants. You get what I'm saying? And drinking out their brew and wanting to drink champagne and look after their pitney them. That's what they need to do. They need to play a part in their pitney them's life. That's what they need to do. So that doesn't, especially the boy pitney them. Because the thing is, right, what women fail to respect within bringing up boy children is that you can't bring up a boy if you're a woman properly. You know what I'm saying? Just like a man cannot bring up a girl if he's a man. You can bring them up and you can pat yourself on the back thinking you're doing the best job. But you haven't got the hormones a boy has got as a woman. You haven't got the hormones a woman has got as a man. Yeah? So how on earth can you see that? You get what I'm saying? How on earth can you be able to manage that? Boys need men. And the lack of men is causing this upsurge and this violent thing in our community. It's the lack of proper men. Half of the men are in jail and the other half are with white girls. And the other half are not, you know, if you can call them halves, you get what I'm saying? The other, you know, percentage, you know, absentee fathers. And then the other women are looking for love and looking for attention. So they're having children and having some company around them at night time and during the day. And sometimes lacking in parental skills too. Because just because you're a mother don't make you a great parent automatic. Because I know girls who fail drastically at that, you know, being a mother. Them things, not being a mother don't just come natural. You get what I'm saying? You have to have, it might come natural if you got role models. If you got somebody, if you got somebody to look up. If you got somebody to look up to. Yeah, if you got somebody, you know, if you got a grandmother or a mother who, you know what I'm saying, that was around and showed you, yeah, you can be natural then. But if you don't have no clue on how to bring up a child, how on earth do you think you're going to bring it up just by having it? You know what I'm saying? Or by dressing it up like a Barbie doll or buying the name brand or whatever. You get what I'm saying? That doesn't do it. You get what I'm saying? That doesn't do it at all. Ah, man, no, you know what I'm saying? Them boys in Wandsworth, if Woolwich, if you're listening to Greenwich, don't be on that, man. That's unnecessary. You know what I'm saying? And the thing is, like, it's not like even, like, you'd crowd around some white boys and do that. You know what I'm saying? You get what I'm saying? You know, you're just, like, chicken. You know what they say? Chicken shit. You know what I'm saying? Or as a man would say, they're just pussy. You get what I'm saying? They're not men. They're not young men. They obviously haven't been treated like young men. You know what I'm saying? They haven't been brought up like young men. They're like young animals. The same set of men that will rape off all young girls and all that. Where are the dads? And we keep hearing about the mothers and the mothers saying, boy, I'm doing the best. Where are the pupa them? Where are the man them? They must be out there. Where are they? They should be, you know, that's the thing about the government, you know, people like say government, man and government. How do you manage your society if you don't have a government that cares about your society? Who's our governors? Who governs our society? Who cares about us? Nobody. We don't even care about ourselves. Who governs these young boys on the road? Where's the youth centres? When the youth centres were there, what was these black people doing? They were taking the government money and building house in Jamaica and taking the government money and filling up their own flat. Because the only thing is that most of the poor people of them, the first time they get a job is the first time they're seeing some of this kind of money. So they can't help but teeth it. They can't help but squander it. because it's the first time they're ever seeing the money. The difference between them and we could call the white people. The white people have a love for their people to see them grow up. Maybe, you know what I'm saying? Because when you're saying that, oh, white people are the devil, so how comes they've done so well then for their own? They're not the devil to their own, then, are they? Even though they have their own wars, which shows you that any people would have their own wars. Irish, Scottish, it doesn't matter. We're not. There's nothing something special about black people fighting against each other. We're not a special kind of race. In Africa, we were fighting with each other long before we become slaves. Yeah. You understand? So, what, you know, this kind of fake idea, this unreal idea that in Africa it's all peace and harmony and the land of milk and honey and all that, it's rubbish. It's never been that way through no part of history. Always been war. Always been fighting, faction fighting, tribal fighting. So what? Don't get mistakes. So what we're saying is that who's governing us? Because the people them who we're electing are so you know, now we're looking for Trevor Phillips as the Lord. He's a white boy. Jules was saying to me, well, boy, yeah, him do this and him do that. So, you get what I'm saying? For me, Dr. X is like, what does that do? You get what I'm saying? Because the moment he, whether he's doing that or not, the moment he sides with us and make them know that he's on our side, he's done for. Because they don't really want to see him there. But if he's the kind of man that will act like a white guy, they would want to see him there. That's what they want to see. Yeah. You don't see Pantel. It shows you. I'm not need to convince you anything. Ainsley Harriet, look at all these bug-eyed, shuffshoeing, you know what I'm saying, people that they got on television, saying they're black entertainers. Yeah. Because they're willing to bow and scrape and act exactly the way the white man wants them to act, to pay their bills. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And that's why men like us, we need to break free of the jail. We can't get through because of them people there. Yeah. Because they don't want to see real black people yet. You got people like, what the guy the name, Long Good Friday? Bob Hoskins. You get what I'm saying? You got man like Mac Vicker who robbed X amount of post offices and banks and all that. Did X amount of jail sentence and escaped from jail X amount of time and is an established writer. Frankie the Mad Hatter or something like that from East London. All these people are name brand and they're criminals. You understand? Because white people are not afraid to let through their society. It's their society. Yeah. Vinnie Jones who kick over a man. You know what I'm saying? The other French boy who kick over a boy all in the crowd. What do you think would have happened to a black man if he jumped in a crowd and kicked over a boy? What do you think would have happened to him? If he never disintegrated him, I don't know what else would have happened to him. But this what's his name? Cantona. You know what I'm saying? He's still playing football like normal. Like everything is everything. Because he's white. And white people will see the error of his ways and allow him. You see, black people, they don't have that. So when he keeps claiming that they're the most soulful and the most decent, they're not that. They're the most hateful people. Yeah. You get what I'm saying? Or they can be, should I say, the most hateful people. Yeah. You get what I'm saying? The most disgusting people. You know what I'm saying? The most uneducated, the most tribally segregational people, the most prejudiced people, the most racist people, black people. Why should I always just be, well, I'm not Farrakhan. I'm not going to be going, yeah, and we live and we're, I'm not bullshitting nobody for the sake of my God or nothing. I'm telling you what I see out there, what everybody knows is out there. You get what I'm saying? Why is youths going on like that? Because they don't have no papa. That's why. The dad is busily smoking and drinking out his life. And the other ones are just busily in jail. Or the other ones just don't even want to know. Yeah. They were the white girl. Huh? Or gambling out the money. Bookie shopping out the money. Yeah. That's why that's what I'm saying. Certain man. That's why I don't even chat to certain man.
Yeah, you're through to Genesis.
Yeah, we say don't take.
Yeah, is that Big T? Yeah, what are you saying, man? Yeah, man. Yes, sir. Everything's Chris.
You know the last statement you just made just a minute ago, yeah? About, with the dad, them.
Yeah, yeah.
Because not like, enough dads saying things like, you know what, the mum lock off the youth from them. That's number one excuse.
Mm.
And there's another one where, when they see their youth, see? Mm. Like, when they see their youth, yeah, the only thing they do is just buy them things.
Try to buy their affection, for real. That, yeah,
they
true.
Don't teach them anything, just buy the
PlayStation and all that kind of stuff.
You understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That's the worst thing you can do, buy a little 6-year-old or whatever, a PlayStation.
Mm-hmm. He just sees you as,
it's gone from them.
Yeah, he just sees you as a money train in that
That's
way.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. Because a lot of them, man, they're uneducated themselves, aren't
they? That's right, there you
go. You know what I'm saying? They don't have nothing to offer. But the women, the women are choosing these men without a prior knowledge or the brains of this man, you know, to find out what type of man they're for. You know what I'm saying? Because they don't realize that it's in the DNA. You know, we've gone past that stage now. You now know that if a man, you're breeding for you, it's not because he's driving a Chris car, because he could be an idiot and drive a Chris car.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody can drive a Chris car. What? How did he get to get? How did he get to do it? You know what I'm saying? Did you hear about this guy who in America who sued his wife because she breed for him when she said she was on the pill?
No, I never heard of that.
Yeah, there's a man in America. He lost though. But he's saying that he's appealing. It was on one of them talk shows, Lisa or one of them things. Yeah.
And cable. Is that cable one?
Is Lisa cable?
Yeah, I think, she's cable,
Well, I saw it in a video shop.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? I didn't see it on my telly or nothing. I was in the video shop, and I stopped in the video shop and was watching it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And I'm saying to my, and I was saying to the brother, boy, you know, black man wouldn't even try that because he's to shame. That's why, you know what I'm saying? If your girl is giving you problem with your youth, then you not got to government. Where else you got to go? You got nowhere else to go. Mm-hmm. You're a coward. You're copping out when you can't get to see your youth and then go to the pub or to some dance and say, boy, yeah, I want to see my youth, them and all, but true, you know what I mean? So there's things you can do if you truly love your youths then.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because she will go to CSA. She goes to government. She goes to government for the family plan. What is it? We don't call it the child support thing book. Innit? So if she can go to government, then black man can go to government too. You know what I'm saying? When I try to play out like him, big and badder than government and nasty and picking them. You understand? That's just a joke business a man's on. You know what I'm saying? He doesn't really want, a lot of them don't want to see their picnic. They use it as excuse, because if you say to your brethren, boy, rare, obviously you're gonna see him a funny way if he's gonna say, I know I want to see them. You can say, well, my brethren's a bit funny. So he can say to you, yeah, well, I want to see them, you know, but Marjorie, she kind of weird. She kind of don't want to see them, and she lock him up. Lock off who? Yeah, youth? Because you don't want to pay no money, that's why. Because you don't want to treat her like somebody, that's why. You know what I'm saying? Not saying that everyone's the same, though.
I tell you something, see, you know how much youth I hear say things like, you know, boy, they also see their mum or even dad, you know what I'm saying? They would even spit in their face. When I hear them things, I said, boy, look, some little youths, you know?
Yeah?
Yeah, man. Some little youths, you know what I'm saying? You know, they talk about their dad, this and that. You know, they wouldn't even spit in his face and all the things. So I'm just saying to myself, what was the dad doing when they were youths?
That's it, isn't it?
But what I'm saying?
But what the thing is the blame goes around in a full circle, blood. Mm. What on earth was that mother who claiming this and that doing with that man in the first place?
Mm.
A lot of the stories, boy, I mean, never knew him was like this and Ray, and all that
I'm
stuff.
I'm good.
So, you got what I'm saying? So what, you know, so again, that's what I was saying in the other show when I was saying to you that, you know, the mothers and fathers of the first have as much to blame as anybody else, because they taught us nothing. They knew nothing to teach us. Everybody's guessing up in this. You get what I'm saying? Everybody's going along guessing. And then the next people like me come out and people want to try and lock it off. And all we're trying to do is stop the guessing game. We're trying to educate people as to the reality of life as an African or a black person or an Afro-Caribbean or whatever, to say this is how life really is. It isn't Cinderella and the seven dwarfs and all that. What on earth is a girl doing with a yard with a 7½ midget man? That not sound right? You know what I'm saying? What the earth is one woman sleeping for how much 100 years and the man kiss her? Yeah, kiss a woman who has slept for 100 years and you now kiss your wife who sleep last night and wake up.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? A lot of it doesn't make sense in reality, but in the fantasy world, it's, oh yes, and they rode off and they live happily. Them never talk about all the nappy have to change after, happily ever after. Or when she got to toilet and the husband come in there and say, oh, that stinks there. First spray the fresh air. You know what I'm saying? That's what happens in reality. When you live with a girl, she will go to the toilet and doo-doo in the toilet. And the toilet will stink. Mm. You get what I'm saying? And you'd have to spray the fresh air and vice versa. Some men like to read all their magazine and smoke all the fog in the cigarette. And just, Dean, you know, like my old man used to stay in all the toilet for all half hour reading the Sunday paper. And he's got a couple of fogs. And he's just smoking and reading. And he thought that was the flex.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Meanwhile, his girl's trying to get in there and saying he's on the lung. When you live with somebody, there is no happily ever after. You got to what? Work it out. Mm. And enough of them don't even know that. So they see this pretty guy who's got a nice BMO, looks Chris, got or whatever, the name brand trainers, deal with him. Oh, it's my boyfriend. I love him. It's my boyfriend. I'm going to take him to meet mommy because he's my boyfriend. I love him. And then him a breeder. Him breeder and then him gone. You know what I'm saying? Him never want no baby and Rary. The two of them go on like two half either. Mommy didn't. Mommy a try to be modern mommy. Not even really a check out certain thing. Not even a watch where a youth are though. The youth no know nothing. The youth no know say if the boy push him hood inside of her, she and he hasn't got a condom on and she's not on the pill, that means pregnancy. I love him. What, 16? You don't know nothing about love. How many 16-year-olds do you know that has had child at the age of 16 that's still with their man? It's almost like a 0%. Maybe I've got a brethren who's been with his girl from school, but that's like, you know what I mean? That's low percentages, blood. That's like, you don't do things. So the reality is out there, but these people who are so-called in power are not teaching them nothing. You get me, blood?
Right. Uh-huh.
And we are part of it. You know what I'm saying? All these guys who have got the radio stations, Choice and all that, they're helping to keep us in this jail, in this darkness, because they are living better. The directors of Choice are living big life. You know what I mean? They have Mercedes and this and that and rare. I'm not saying man's not to have that, but I'm saying in order to keep that, they need to keep doing what they're doing. Because the moment they do that, they're putting that in jeopardy, and they're not doing that for no one.
Yeah.
So they will destroy people to keep their lifestyle. Just old slate or, you know, normal, you know, plain coloured capitalism. Nothing different. You can't live capitalism and then try to act socialistic. Mm. You're either a capitalist or you're a socialist. You know what I'm saying? In a sense, it's political, in that sense. If you want to live in, like, a socialistic, like a co-op, you know about the bank, the co-op bank? They don't invest because they're a cooperative. They don't have hierarchies.
Yeah.
You understand? Then you have, Jamaica's in such turmoil? Because Manly met up with a communist called Castro, Fidel Castro. And from that moment on, America fed guns. America, through the CIA, fed guns into Jamaica. Jamaica has no gun-making facilities. Jamaica has no reason to ship guns in from America. Yeah? This is what you call political destabilization. So America, because they didn't want Jamaica to link up with Cuba, because then obviously they would start a chain reaction, isn't it? Remember, Cuban is still a communist country, and they've tried to kill Castro X amount of time. Yeah. They've asked for Cubans to leave from Cuba and go to America. And what did Castro do? He sent them all his criminals.
Mm.
So they've got a low percentage of illiteracy, about 2%. So everybody's got education over there. Everybody's got access to health over there.
Right.
You understand? So isn't that a better life as an African is concerned? You know what I'm saying? To live more socialistic. But we can't, because we live in a capitalist community, or what you call a democratic one. And a lot of these men and Choice and all these guys who get into these magazines and all that, they're capitalists. And if you're a capitalist, that means you need to keep things going for the so that you can reign and conserve the status quo. Because you can bet your bottom dollar, if not this election, but the next election, Conservatives will be back in.
Yeah.
It's just a game they're playing. Both of them are capitalists. In order to have a decent fight, one would have to be a socialist, proper socialist, and the other one a capitalist. So you have two different types of systems. All you've got is two capitalists. One who run it this way as a capitalist, and another one running that as a capitalist. So what do you expect? You get what I'm saying? A capitalist is somebody who seeks to make capital. That's why we're in such a state. We don't care. Capitalists don't necessarily care about people. They just care about profit. What I'm saying, that's the kind of political situation we're living in. You know what I'm saying? This capitalistic situation, it's not an ideal one, but that's what it is. So when people are telling you that they're your friend and they're trying to, you know, help the community, they're not. If there's no money in it for them, they're not going to do nothing, because they're capitalists. That's what capitalists are all about. So one has, you have got to learn to understand that. You know what I'm saying? Just say to a brother, boy, you're a capitalist. And that's a cuss to me. You know what I'm saying? Because that's all you want to do. Guy, you're a capitalist.
Yeah.
That means that you only want to feed off of poor people. Because that's all capitalists do. You know, abuse people for their profit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's what a drug seller is. He's a capitalist. He don't care. I'm not saying somebody who's selling a look at herb and all that, because we know about the healing and all that. But somebody who's selling soul-destroying drugs. It's like a doctor who will sell you all kinds of manner of drugs that they make on the in the NHS and all that rubbish that they make. He will sell it to you. You say you have a look at heart problem, him selling this new drug where they just compound the thing. You know what I'm saying? Because you lost your way in your Africanness. You know, see them. You have to let white people lead you back to your Africanness. So white people start aromatherapy, which they took from Africa. White people start herbalism, and they have to build it themselves. You, what? You black people haven't got a clue. You're just out there, just sitting down there, waiting for white people to do something. So it's all right for you to do it. You know what I mean? Like the funky dreads and all that. You know, I remember when Rasta couldn't even go into certain clubs. Couldn't go, you know what I'm saying, couldn't go certain places. And as soon as it was able for the capitalists to get involved, everybody, them little mothers and fathers are sending their children to school with funky dreadlocks.
Yeah.
And one time Rasta was nasty. To have your locks in your ear was nastiness.
Yeah.
You understand? So what has gone on? What has gone on? You're just following everything. You haven't got no power in yourself. You haven't got no strength or no identity in yourself. You get your identity from your master. The master is still the white man. You're still in the prison. You need to break free.
Yeah.
You understand? That's what you need to do. You need to keep hold of your mind. You need to control yourself. You get what I'm saying? The fathers need to get on the roads and look out for these people. You get what I'm saying? Yeah. Annette was right when she said that, yeah, we come together as mothers. Look how she just said mother, because she just thinks that's the normal thing to do. What about the pupa them? What about the man them? What are the man them doing other than playing sound system? What are the man them doing other than playing football on a Sunday in the park? What are the man them doing? They need to be brought to bear. That's why government right for send CSA after them. Where they put pressure upon them on that, because somebody's got to do something. Because they don't want to destroy their community. That's why. They don't care about our community, but they're worried about their own.
Yeah.
We don't care about our own. Otherwise, these girls wouldn't, you know, these mothers wouldn't keep letting their daughters go out. They can't be bothered. The daughter's got some short skirt all up to the pum-pum line. You get what I'm saying? And then she does it, and she's going to dance with a guy. Now, on earth, if a girl's half naked, you tell me any man. I'm a man, I know. You know what I'm saying? You tell me any man, boy, who's not going to have get a woody over that. You understand? It's just like, you know, this is real. You know, and girls dance with a man and his things are stiff. And that's what is the flex. The deeper the dance, the stiffer the thing. And she's in her. It's just a sexual thing. And that's how you get to know the girl. At the end of the night, you take her number. You don't even talk to her. The most you do is dance with her and buy her a drink.
Yeah, what's your name?
Yes, Vicky. Yeah, see. Yeah, what's the number? 37475. You know what I'm saying? And that's the check. Yeah, I'll phone you tomorrow, yeah? All right. Boom, that's it. Then you phone him tomorrow. He pulls up in his Mercs or whatever he's driving because he save up to get a good car so he can catch girl.
Yeah.
Men with no mindsets. He save up all his wages to get a good car on HP. And you go, and your friends go, who's that? He drives a nice car. As if the car maketh the man. You know, what kind of little empty house check that you go into every Saturday night, the dance hall's full up a man looking. They just walk around like vultures. You see them. They walk around, yeah? And then they screech you behind. They see a girl. It's like lions in the jungle. They not even lions. Sharks and all them little carochins, yeah? They got to sneak around. Then they ease up behind the girl and they start to edge. And they see her and they, I'm going to check her. I'm going to pull her for a dance. And they edge a little bit more. Till they screechy up behind the girl, yeah? And then she's there standing up and all of a sudden she feels a tug on her arm. You know what I'm saying? This is the brother, he wants to dance. That's how he approaches her. From behind, like a coward, and tugs on the arm. Like a primitive animal. Dance. You want to dance with me? You know what I'm saying? She turns around, rub. Next thing, what's your name? Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, what's your number? Yeah? Yeah. And that's the check.
Yeah.
That's how deep as black people go. Every Saturday night.
Yeah.
Some of them are sad people. Some of the girls are very, very sad, trust me. And some of the men are double sad.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, remember, the days are finished. We're not slaves anymore. Free.
Yeah.
We're not slaves. We don't have to check people. You know, this ain't like when we work all day, but I don't know another man working on the chain. Gang, you know what I'm saying? It's no more like that. So every Saturday night now, all we got is the only time we get to meet up with our girl to get a little quick grind off of her or a little quick sex or love making, any way you want to call it. You can call it what you like. You get what I'm saying? But it's sex. You get what I'm saying? On a Saturday or a weekend when the work is done, it's over. We don't have to do that no more. You get me? We don't know, the slavery is finished now. That level, that phase of slavery is gone. So you don't need to be going to the girl and be, you know, be the DJ and all the DJs just there playing his music and his girl's out there and he's got two girls, one he checked at his other dance and the two of them are out there and he's here maxing like he's a notch. And he's defending nothing. He's got nothing to offer the two of them except his dick. And then they struggle for him, like the two girls. Boy, I saw him chatting to Margie. Yeah, I saw him chatting to Deirdre. And, you know what I'm saying? And over what? Because he's a DJ. That's why half of these guys have turned to them guys. That's the only ego boost they get. You know what I'm saying? That's the only ego boost they can find in life. Even though they play music. You know what I'm saying? And these petty little small-minded things is what, like, look at them 11 boys that attacked that guy. What do you think they're going to turn out to be? You think they're going to turn out to be upstanding citizens? Unless I can get in contact with them or somebody can, they're not going to, boy, it's going to take a miracle. You know what I'm saying? What's up with that, man? I don't understand. I'm just lost. Why people are repeating like they're lost. This lust and lust, quite close names, aren't they? Yeah? Like they're lost. You know what I'm saying? Just going around every weekend, the same thing, day in, day out.
Night rules, the right moves. Hey, you just get down to night moves, over 21s. The right moves. Yeah, you got to know.
Yeah, what? You know what I'm saying? And the brothers them in there like trying to, some of them acting like they're bad man and who thinking that they've, some of them used to go to church for most of their life and because they see that bad man's getting most of the girls, they try to act bad because they want girls too. What kind of sad, I'm not saying because they're not the only people, because there's some nice guys out there probably, you know, computer little analysts and mathematicians and there's a whole set of them out there too, but they're just as bad. You know what I'm saying? I know a situation right now where a man in a fairly decent job is pregnant a girl and won't you know, do the fathership thing. You get what I'm saying? And he's a well-to-do man. He got himself involved in a situation which you know about. This playing away thing. This playing the field thing that you can't, a lot of the man them are scared, can't manage. You get what I'm saying? They play out, breed the girl. She wants a baby. The girl wants a baby. You get what I'm saying? She's whatever and she doesn't mind. But see, the more you have, unless she's got money, unless, why? You're coming like third world up in England. It's only third world that they breed like that. Because they've got nothing better to do. You've got cable, you've got internet, you've got computer, you've got theatres, you've got libraries, you've got places to go, you've got places to walk, parks to hold your girl's hand in, you've got places to take your children's, you've got Alton Towers, you've got places to go, blood. You don't need to be sexing and breeding like hogs up in this. This isn't the third world. What happened to the man them and their man youth them, because it's the man youth them that's raping. It's not the girl that are raping off the man them. The girls are smarter still, because a lot of set of the girls them, you know, they're lacking a certain love from their either their father or their mother, or their father wants to give them too much love to the point where he thinks this is right to have sex with her. You understand what I'm saying? This is what's happening in the black community and not a lot of other communities, by the way. You get what I'm saying? But this is a part of our particular situation. You know what I'm saying? Why would, you know what I'm saying? Why can't these people be brought to bear? Why can't these people be hang out so that we can see who they are and say, yeah, you can. You know what I'm saying? You're off that. Because, you know what I'm saying? The only way we're going to be able to deal with certain things is to face the truth, star. Check it. You can't do it no other way. Youths are out there and they got nothing, they got no, they're looking for something. That's why they breed so young, because they're lacking in, maybe one in a thousand girls might breed, you get what I'm saying, for an accident. The rest of them, a lot of them, they're looking for something, star. You know what I'm saying? Mother or father hasn't engaged them in enough conversation, enough loving lifestyle, enough pleasurable lifestyle to make them feel a bit at ease, ill at ease with that. But then even if you do that to the girls, then the man them are still messed up. You know what I'm saying? The man them are still lacking in certain. They see a girl, she's walking down the road in the shorter skirt she can find, and they're all this stiffing up in their car, and they want to rape her off. You know what I mean? She one walking down the road. Girls, if you're going to dress half naked when summertime come, every summertime, God send, there is a rape, a major rape. I mean, I'm not even reading the papers, too tough, and I'm still hearing about it. Every summertime, summer holiday, it's the same thing in the black community. So haven't you, what does it take for the mothers and fathers to learn? Who's busily watching them? They're not. They're busily out smoking in the in Woolmer Castle, in Chopper, you know what I'm saying, in the Beaufort Arms. That's where they're all heading. They're not about their children. They don't, you know, meanwhile, their children sneaking in their boyfriend to have sex. But they don't care because they say, don't make nobody come in here. And as far as they can say, no, mommy, no. And boom, as if that is strong enough. You know what I'm saying? You got to, you know, where do you go with your child? So that your child, you can't wake up one day and when your child's 18, want them to come somewhere with you. And they've never been nowhere with you all their life. There's no habit to them. You got to start to be walking with your child from their youths. That's why a lot of the youths that are already done, they're done. You got to make your child have respect for himself, herself, and for people. But this lifestyle that we're living, when the Yardie man's got, you know, 10 gal, the English man's got 6 gal, you know what I'm saying? Them lifestyle, they can't work unless the man who's got the picnic them can defend it. You know what I'm saying? It's ridiculous. You know what I'm saying? And through the music and that, you know what I'm saying? It's like, fuck, you know what I'm saying? It's just madness has been sent out to the people them, encouraging them the same foolishness. You get what I'm saying? Madness, sickness, rubbishness. What's up with that, man? Ain't it about time we start to say, well, boy, you know what I'm saying? What a guan. Sometimes you're to not sat there, you're to stay in your bed. You're to catch out two video. And stay in your bed. You know what I'm saying? Or sometimes you have to sit down with your youth. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, read a book with your youth. You get what I'm saying? Encourage your youth to do things. From young, it's no good waiting until he's become spoiled or she's become spoiled and then trying it when they're all 15, 14, 15. They're already finding their way. Do it from them barn. It's too late now. We're like in beer trouble. Because who's going to turn around and help all them youths them who are already gone astray? There is nowhere for them to go. Except to the government system. And then the man is going to say, boy, I may give up. And the mother is going to say, boy, I may give up. We can't manage him. Why did you bother? Why did you bother if you can't manage? Or did you bother? What do you think? It's like, you know, like them people that buy dogs.